Ever wonder what a Finnish Savu Sauna is? Did you know one was involved in one of Cokato Township's first lawsuits? Stay tuned to find out more about this steamy story. Savu in Finnish means smoke. Savu saunas, like the Cokato Finnish American Historical Society's sauna at Temperance Corner, would get very smoky because there was no formal stove or chimney to direct the smoke outside.
So what they would do is they would heat the kuis, which is this little rock pile in the corner here, and they would heat that. They'd start a fire in there, but they'd open the lunkas. And the lunkas are what you see on the two sides and the little opening above me, above my head. And these were just to let the air into the building, because again, you had an open fire with no chimney in here. So they would keep heating, and they'd have to start like on a Saturday morning and heat all day long. And then by early evening, late afternoon, they'd let the fire go out, and then they would clean the ashes out. And once they had the ashes out, then this would eliminate the carbon monoxide, if you will, that was in the building. Then they could shut the lunkas, and then they could have your sauna. The rocks, of course, got really hot, and this is, you created steam by throwing water onto the rocks. They had a kettle like the copper one on the stove, and this is what they would use to heat the water with.
Taking a sauna was a common practice amongst Cokato's Finnish settlers, providing relief to their tired muscles and getting their bodies clean after a long week of hard labor.
It became a social activity because this was the chance to get together. Nobody ever heated the sauna just for their own use, or not typically. They would heat it for relatives, for friends, and for neighbors to come over. And they would take turns having the sauna and then having a sauna pala, which is a coffee afterwards, and this was a social time. It was a chance to get together and to relax.
An important part to their life and culture, Cokato Finns took great care in building their saunas to withstand harsh Minnesota weather.
One thing I always like to point out to people is just the construction, first of all, because it's all hewn log. This is a sauna from 1868, but it's dovetail, compound dovetail corners. And those are extremely strong. The building sits together very well, and they're also all self-draining so that they don't rot. So the logs are, for being 150 years old, are very good condition. And they were expert carpenters for the time, because I like to point out for people the door. This is compound wedges in the door. If you look at them, they're V-cut. And there's a slot cut into the door, and so they actually self-lock, and they stay really tight, and all the moisture again runs out. So it's kind of a unique feature for the building.
The Savu Sauna that now sits at Temperance Corner was once involved in a lawsuit. This is the story.
This sauna again was built in 1868, and it was built on the Township Road, and it was built by two neighbors, Selvalas and Barbergs, and it served three families. There were three Finnish families there, and it served all three of them for about 20 years. And then in the after this time, a separate sauna was built. My great-grandpa built a log sauna, or a frame sauna, and so this sauna was there. But it was sold, his rights were sold to Selvala, and Selvala then had it. And during this time, the County Road 100 here became very popular, and it was used by a lot of non-Finns, and they couldn't believe the fact that there is no dressing room in a sauna. The activities in a sauna are the same thing as that you would have in church. There's no hanky-panky or anything going on, and the Finns are not concerned about it. And so they would dress outside, or dress modestly outside and go into the house to get fully dressed. But the non-Finns said this was terrible, so the Cokato Township said that they had to move the sauna and they were only going to pay Selvola a few dollars in damages. And so he said, it's my sauna on my property, and he took them to court. So this was the first lawsuit that was held in Cokato Township, and he won, and so he not only got paid damages, but he got the cost, the price of having to move the sauna, which because of the log construction has to be torn down from the very top and down to the bottom logs and moved, and he reassembled it and then reassembled it with a dressing room on it. So that's kind of the story here.
In the late 1970s, the controversial Barberg, Selvola, and Salmonson sauna was moved to Temperance Corner. It is currently under the care of the Cokato Finnish American Historical Society. To learn more steamy sauna history, visit the Cokato Finnish Historical Society website. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.